رب العالمين الصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله
الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله
وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا حبيب الله
وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا حبيب الله
الصلاة والسلام عليك يا نبي الله
الصلاة والسلام عليك يا نبي الله
وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا نور الله
وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا نور الله
سيدنا أبو هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه narrates that the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam said, may the man who does not recite durood upon me when I am mentioned be disgraced. May the man who spends Ramadan but does not gain forgiveness before its departure be disgraced. May the man who have old parents but is not put into heaven due to respecting and serving them be disgraced. Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madni channel, we welcome you all in another silsila of Madni Mukalma. Today we have a very special silsila, because in our silsila today there is two things which is special about this silsila. One is that our conversation is going to be on a special occasion. And secondly, we have brothers from two different parts of the world in our Madani Mukalma today. And inshallah azawajal, you will find it very beneficial to know how two different countries have the issues of this topic. And the topic of today is how to celebrate Eid. Before we start on our topic, we will start with the recitation of the Holy Quran.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لا يستوي أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة أصحاب الجنة هم الفائزون لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل لرأيته خاشعا متصدعا من خشية الله لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل لرأيته خاشعا متصدعا من خشية الله وتلك الأمثال نضربها للناس لعلهم يتفكرون صدق الله العظيم
سبحان الله. My dear Islam brothers and viewers of Madni channel, let's for a moment try to close our eyes and imagine we are in the beautiful city of Medina.
Subhanallah.
And in front of the Rosa of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we will listen to a very beautiful kalam.
Sallallahu alayka ya Rasulullah, Sallallahu alayka ya Habiballah. Aaya hai bulawa phir ek baar Madine ka, aaya hai bulawa phir ek baar Madine ka, phir jaake main dekhunga, phir jaake main dekhunga darbar Madine ka, aaya hai bulawa ek baar Madine ka, main phool ko chumunga aur dhool ko chumunga, main phool ko chumunga aur dhool ko chumunga, jis waqt karunga main deedar Madine ka, jis waqt karunga main deedar Madine ka, aankhon se laga lunga aur dil mein basa lunga, aankhon se laga lunga aur dil mein basa lunga, seene mein utarunga main khar Madine mein, seene main utarunga main khar Madine ka, seene mein Madina ho aur dil mein Madina ho, seene mein Madina ho aur dil mein Madina ho, aankhon mein bhi ho naqsha sarkar Madine ka, aankhon mein bhi ho naqsha sarkar Madine ka, rote hain jo deewane betab hain mastane, rote hain jo deewane betab hain mastane, in sab ko dikha dije darbar Madine ka, in sab ko dikha dije darbar Madine ka, qabze mein do alam hai par haath ka takiya hai, sota hai chatai par sardar Madine ka, dukh dard jahan bharke sab dur shaha karke, mujhko to bana lije bimar Madine ka, is dar ke bhikari ki jholi mein do alam ہے شاہوں سے بھی بڑھ کر ہے نادار مدینے کا مقبول جہاں بھر میں ہو دعوت اسلام مقبول جہاں بھر میں ہو دعوت اسلام مقبول جہاں بھر میں ہو دعوت اسلام صدقہ تجھے اے رب غفار مدینے کا تقدیر چمک اٹھے قسمت ہی تو کھل جائے تقدیر چمک اٹھے قسمت ہی تو کھل جائے بن جائے جو ادنا سگ عطار مدینے کا بن جائے جو ادنا سگ عطار مدینے کا آیا ہے بلاوا پھر ایک بار مدینے کا پھر جا کے میں دیکھوں گا دربار مدینے کا.
سبحان اللہ عز و جل, الحمدللہ, such beauty in the kalam of Amir al-Sunnat. My dear Islam brothers and viewers of Madni channel, our topic today, how to celebrate Eid. You might be thinking, what we're going to discuss on how to celebrate Eid here. But more or less we're going to talk about how we as Muslims are celebrating Eid in the UK and in South Africa, and try to put these things together and focus on this, that where are we going wrong. So inshallah Zawajal, we'll be speaking on this, that how we should be celebrating Eid and how the previous people, the Sahaba Ikram, the Awliya Allah, how they celebrated Eid also. As mentioned about Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, that once Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu saw his son on the day of Eid wearing toed clothes. Allah. Clothes which had patches in them. Allah. And Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he started to cry. Tears started to flow from his eyes. That when he started to cry, his son asked him, that, oh my dear father, why are you crying? What has made you cry? And Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala said, when other children will see you wearing these clothes, what would they say? What would they think of you? And when the son of Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu heard these painful words from his father, he replied that my heart should not break. The heart of that person breaks who could not approve Allah Azza wa Jal, or the one who disobeyed his father. And I am hopeful that because of gaining your happiness, Allah Azza wa Jal will be happy with me. And after listening to this, Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala started to cry and embraced his son and gave him blessing. My dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madni channel, this was the way those people celebrated Eid. How simple, with how much love, that even on days like this they would be crying. How much sympathy, they spend the days of Eid. And if you look at us today, how we are spending Eid. Just think for a moment, my dear Islam brothers and viewers of Bandi Channel, how we are spending Eid. And how them, those people, how they spend the days of their Eid. It all starts from, as the last fast is coming, and you know, we are so keen that tomorrow may not be Roza, may not be another day of fast, but be a day of Eid. Whereas those people, the previous people, and even the great walis of this day and time, people like Shaykh Tariqat Amir al-Sunnat, when they know Ramadan is ending, what be the state of Amir al-Sunnat? How Abapa Jan, Amir al-Sunnat, how he starts to cry when knowing that Ramadan is leaving and the blessed month is leaving us and it's going to be the day of Eid. And you know, this would be the state before the coming of the day of Eid. And if you look at it today, then before even the day of Eid comes, what is our state? You know, how is our state the day before Eid? You know, we should think, it's mentioned about some countries that the day before Eid, the people begin to plan that, shall we drink alcohol tonight? Shall we celebrate Eid in this way tonight, the day before Eid, or on the Eid day? And these is the state of the Muslims. And we will see these issues in South Africa, what is the state of the people before Eid, and also in the UK, what is the state of the Muslims before Eid?
Actually, in South Africa also we have a very similar situation, whereby people are joyful when the last night of Ramadan arrives, and they're waiting impatiently for the Imam to make the announcement in the masjid that the moon has been sighted and tomorrow is Eid. Actually, the system in South Africa at the moment is that moon is sighted in the southern province, which is the Cape Peninsula, Cape Town, and thereafter the phone calls are flying throughout the entire country. People are phoning each other, all Imams are phoning each other, and thereafter the announcement is made in the masjid. And when the announcement is made in the masjid, there is actually an enjoyment coming out from the Muslims in every masjid that tomorrow is Eid, and everybody starts to celebrate. But however, you do get some groups of individuals, those who Beloved Rasulullah has mentioned about them, that if my ummah knew what Ramadan really is, they would wish that may it be Ramadan, Ghuriyatru. So there are some ashiks that were in the masjid. Announcement is made, but actually they are not enjoyed. They are actually in a state of...
But how much people can that be? You know, maybe a handful. You could probably count them on your fingers. Gee. But you know, whereas the state of the people, the majority are in enjoyment. The majority are lost in the love of the world.
As you mentioned, yes, it's like you said, as soon as the sun sets of the last day of Ramadan, you know, we have the brothers and sisters shopping till late, till 1, 12, 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock in the morning. The barber shops are full.
But prior to that,
they go in and hiring vehicles. Hundreds and thousands of pounds are spent just hiring vehicles. And then, like we said, on that very night, like I said, they're waiting for that moment. And sometimes they say, if somebody says no, it's not tomorrow, they'll make excuses and say so and so Imam said this and so on. Why don't we compromise and we celebrate on one day, and this is happening and that happened, just excuse that so we can indulge into sins.
You know, just thinking for a moment, like I mentioned earlier, that people actually make this mind that should we drink tonight or should we drink tomorrow on the day of Eid. You know, What has come of the nation, of the ummah? And this is showing the state we are in. And This is not just Eid, even before that, even in Ramadan, you will find that when in the nights of Ramadan, where are the Muslims?
See, what it is, I think we keep forgetting the purpose of fasting. Throughout the whole 30 days when we are fasting, on that very night when the fasting is over, Ramadan's over, we're waiting for that particular call so we can basically lose everything. All the good actions, all the virtues we accumulated through that month, and within split seconds, like I said, you know, the shaitan's released on that night, and he's released, so he's actually waiting, so he's saying, okay, all that month I've been away, you know, let me come out and, you know, I'll put you back on the same track. So we don't realize that we need to do fikr, you know, we need to reflect on the hereafter, we need to reflect that for the whole month, what have I been doing for the whole 30 days, that I've been going to Taraweeh, I've been reading my namaz with Jamaat, and what's happened all of a sudden is just because of one particular day, the special occasion, we lose everything. So that particular night we said, like, the brothers and sisters, you know, they're out and rejoicing, and like I said, you know, throughout the whole month they read namaz, Fajr namaz with Jamaat, and that morning of Eid,
it actually shows how fiercely Shaitan comes out on the last day. Because according to the narration that in the month of Ramadan,
yes,
Shaitan is locked away.
Allah,
he's locked away.
Allah.
And if he's locked away, the Shaitan doesn't tempt anybody. He's locked away, but on the last day, Allah Akbar, when Shaitan is freed, you know he's coming back with revenge.
There's a narration here that the devil screams and cries on the day of occasion of Eid. Every year, seeing him crying, the other devils gather around him and ask him, "Oh Master, why are you crying?" They're asking him, "So why are you crying so furiously and you are disappointed today?" He replies, "Regretfully, Allah Azza wa Jal has forgiven the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. So make them indulge in satisfying their carnal desires." So it's all about carnal desires, like we said, prior to like the whole week before Ramadan, when about it's Eid, you know, the shopping centers are full, the city centers are full, they're spending thousands of pounds on expensive clothing.
And it's not just city centers here, you're talking about normal streets. People have come out in normal streets, and not just that, look at the barber shops, an example. You know, it's like music is even playing on that night, and people are sitting there. And
those who make the intention of keeping a beard, what they actually do on that very night, like you said, 1 o'clock in the morning, 2 o'clock in the morning, they are waiting, and Allah forbid, they're shaving the beards off, and then having all these fancy haircuts, right, that, you know, if these brothers you see him the next day, you will not recognize this is the same brother. For 30 days, mashallah, he had a hat on, he had a beard, well, you know, he's trying to grow a beard, but all of a sudden, right, because of his friends, okay, because they're going out the following day, and like we said, the preparations are made weeks before that. Even sometimes you hear brothers talking about this, oh, you know, what we're going to do on Eid, even 2 weeks, 3 weeks before, what we're going to do on Eid, we're going to go here, we're going to do that, we're going to do that. So they're making intentions for sins.
My dear Islam brothers, you know, just think for a moment, what happens on these nights? It's like the hearts of the man, the hearts of mankind have died on this night. And the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam has said, it's mentioned in a narration, that whoever stands and offers salah in the night of Eid, meaning Eid al-Fitr or Eid al-Adha, in order to earn reward, his heart will not die on the day when the hearts of the people will die. So this is one of the things that on that night when we should be thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we should be worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, thanking Him for the blessing of Ramadan, we are lost in the love of the world.
Beautiful saying, Sayyidina Ghawse Azam radiyallahu ta'ala, and people are saying tomorrow is Eid, and everyone is happy, but the day when I leave this world with fate is the day of Eid for me. Everybody is committing sins on a daily basis, especially on Eid days. Our young brothers and sisters go out on one main road, blast the music full blast, and they're drinking, open the windows, they're shouting. If they see a religious person walking past, and they go, "Look at Maulviji is going past, Maulviji is going past."
Allah,
this is the state of our brothers and sisters. Half of our sisters are unveiling, they don't know sharma, haya, modesty, they don't know nothing, and they're committing sin. Allahu Akbar. Very sad when if a religious person walking past is or our hearts puts us down on that day. And there are other people, other religions see us and they say, look at this Muslim, how they behaving? Like completely, look like they just come out of a jungle. That's the state of a Muslim is these days.
And this is just a night of Eid. You know, then there is a day.
Allah.
Now if you spend the night like this, imagine what's going to be the state. You know, first of all, spending the night, the whole night like this, are we going to get up for Fajr? This is the first thing to think about. If the night is spent like this, then the whole of the month of Ramadan, which we'll be performing our namaz Fajr with Jamaat in the masjid, on the day of Eid, it's gone.
Actually, we experienced this in our country, South Africa, that the night of Eid, on the morning of Eid, the masjid starts to get empty. The masjids actually start to get empty. Usually there are hundreds and hundreds of worshippers in the month of Ramadan, but when the day of Eid starts, that's when the masjid starts to get empty.
See, we're forgetting to remember the bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And like he says, on the actual Eid day, we forget to read, miss our Fajr altogether, and sometimes brothers stay sleeping through the Eid. They miss the Eid Salah as well. Sometimes miss the Eid Salah because what's happened prior to the night before that, because they're rejoicing so much and forgetting that, you know, the aim of our creation, why we were here for, and look at the bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this blessed month of Ramadan. And like we said, we lose it within one day, and rather than thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day, spending with your family, visiting your relatives and giving gifts on that day, but we do the opposite. Rather than pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah azza wa jal forbid, we disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
You know, just for a moment here, you know, like you said, Fajr is missed, but I think majority of the people do perform Eid. But Namaz Fajr is farz, it's compulsory. And that is given more power. It's like same with Jummah. A lot of the Muslims will perform Jummah, but when it comes to Namaz-e-Fajr or any other prayer, it's not considered as it being compulsory action. Yes. So my dear Islam brothers and viewers of Madni Channel, you know, up to now we've been discussing the night of Eid, the morning of Eid, the Eid Salah. But although before all this, before the ending of Ramadan, how much everyone is forgiven.
Allah,
so much people are forgiven on that night. And throughout Ramadan, every day people are forgiven.
Actually, Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu narrates that the beloved Rasul of Allah Azza wa Jalla was sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, mercy for all the worlds. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, in Ramadan, every day at the time of iftari, at the time of sunset, Allah Azza wa Jalla frees 1 million sinners. 1 million such sinners from Jahannam, upon whom Jahannam had become wajib due to their guna, due to their sins. And 1 million such sinners who had deserved Jahannam are freed from Jahannam every moment of the day of Friday. Every moment of the day of Friday. Dear Islamic brothers, Subhanallah Azza wa Jalla. Every day in Ramadan, 1 million sinners that have been deserved for Jahannam are forgiven. 1 million sinners are set free from the punishment of Jahannam in every single moment of Friday. And on the last night of Ramadan, Subhanallah Azza wa Jal, sinners are freed equal to the number of people freed from the punishment of the fire throughout the month on that day, on the last day. Subhanallah Azza wa Jal. So how much millions and millions of sinners are forgiven in this Mubarak month of Ramadan?
And still, even knowing that after we might be amongst them people who are forgiven, still going back into sins? After gaining forgiveness, going back into the sinful life, you know, we need to really start reflecting on this.
On the day of Eid, some people came to the house of Sayyidina Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and to meet him and greet him. But the door was closed and the sound of crying was coming from the house. Allahu Akbar. When the doors opened, they asked surprisingly, O Amir al-Mu'mineen radiallahu ta'ala anhu, today's Eid, everyone is delighted, and why are you crying? Allahu Akbar. He radiallahu ta'ala anhu replied, wiping his tears, indeed this is Eid for those whose salah and fast have been accepted. Allahu Akbar. Okay? But it's the day of Eid, warning for those whose salah and fast have been rejected and thrown at their faces. I am crying because of that. This number brothers, Allahu Akbar, ponder over this. Hazrat Farooq Azam radiallahu ta'ala anhu was one of those 10 fortunate companions of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala wasallam, who were blessed with the glad tidings entering Jannah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave glad tidings to the 10 Sahaba ikram al Ridwan, who was one of them, Hazrat Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who was crying on the day of Eid.
I'm sure every Muslim or the viewers of Madni channel might be thinking, you know, shouldn't we be rejoicing on this day, on the day of Eid?
We stay within the limits of Sharia, but we go without the bounds, we go out of the bounds of Sharia. Like you said, disturbing others, hiring cars, then disturbing others and playing loud music, like the brother said before, and then going on the streets. On that actually very day, would you believe it or not, the authorities, the police involved in it. The police is involved in it where there are roadblocks. And these are Muslims. We are supposed to set examples. We are supposed to set examples to others so people follow us.
Do you have something like this in South Africa?
South Africa is a very similar situation. All the kids are starting to drive around with their fast cars, music is blasted, boys and girls getting together in the shopping centers, going up to the shopping malls, to the restaurants, etc., and enjoying themselves. This is exactly what's happening in our country.
So-called Muslims who hired a limousine on the day of Eid, and these sisters had all the windows open of their cars, sticking their heads out, screaming, shouting. This was the state on the day of Eid. Where was the modesty, where was the haya gone at that moment? On the day of Eid. On the day we should be thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this was the state.
You're talking about the Eid. A brother than a Muballigh of Dar al-Islami in Abyan, and what happened was on Eid in UK, one of the streets in UK. These brothers were actually celebrating throughout the night, and they were actually drinking as well, and they were actually going home early part of the morning, and they were travelling on the motorway, and they were actually racing. On the motorway they were racing, and where on the motorway they've actually had an accident, they lost control, hit the central reservation, and the brother had, well, the accident was so severe that when the accident crew came, they actually found his head half a mile down the road.
Allah.
And when they actually done post-mortem on him, and he was over the limits, drink limit. And just 2 weeks prior to that, he just got married 2 weeks prior to that. Can you imagine what went through that family, and just because of that one night, and just alcohol in his body? I mean, you know, we as Muslims just think of this, right? You know, we as Muslims, we were leaders, came here to wipe all this out. But unfortunately, what's happening here is totally the opposite.
Yeah, actually, this is a situation in South Africa as well. In fact, we have many examples where the youngsters get together and they drag race. On that Eid day, they drag racing, and drag racing, eventually to accident. From accident, people are dying.
An Eid day,
yeah, on
Eid
day.
At such a day when the family gets together, meet each other, it's a day of happiness and rejoicing. You know, you want to be happy. And think about it, the people who are doing this, the viewers of Madni channel who are listening, think about it, if you are amongst them people who are doing this action, think about what is going to be the state of your family. When on a day of Eid, on a day of happiness, you are going out doing these things, and what pain are you putting your family into?
On Eid day, we're supposed to be, you know, thanking Allah Azza wa Jal, and performing sunnah, the way our Aqa alayhi salatu wasalam used to wear clothes. But look at our clothes in South Africa, right? The people bring new fashions. They show off, like you see, some of the friends, they show each other like the new clothes, like I'm wearing this brand, you wearing that brand, no, my brand is better, right? And they like competition each other.
And it comes out specially for Eid days?
Yeah, especially.
We're still talking about clothing, and there's one narration that comes here, our Shaykh Tariqat Amir al-Sunnah mentions in this beautiful kitab, the Princess Eid. He talks about Hazrat Sayyidina Umar bin Abdul Aziz, the leader of the believers, Amir al-Mu'mineen. His daughter went to her beloved father on the day of Eid. Two daughters actually, yes, went to the day before Eid and said, she implored that, father, oh Abba Jan, tomorrow is Eid. Which clothes are we going to wear? Hazrat Umar bin Abdul Aziz radiallahu anhu replied, the ones you are wearing, wash them today and wear them tomorrow. Allah, imagine, leader of the believers telling his beloved daughters, the same clothes you are wearing, wash them and wear them tomorrow. No, father, make new clothes for us. The little girls insisted stubbornly, but he radiallahu anhu replied, my wonderful daughters, Eid day is a day on which the ibadah of Allah should be performed. And it's a day to make shukr to Allah. It is not necessary to wear new clothes. Allahu Akbar. Father, no doubt you are right, but our friends and other girls will tease us and they will say that you are the daughters of the leader of the Muslims, and you are still wearing these old clothes. And as they said this, their eyes got filled with tears. On seeing this, the heart of the leader of the Muslims, Amir al-Mu'mineen, also got hurt, and he called the treasurer. He called his treasurer and said, "Give me 1 month's salary in advance."
Allah.
"Give me 1 month's salary in advance." The treasurer said humbly, "Ya Sayyidi, sir, are you radiallahu sure that you will stay alive for 1 month?" Allah Akbar, what a mind, what a thinking. Amir al-Mu'mineen radiallahu replied and he said, "Jazakallahu khair, may Allah tabarakatuhu reward you, may Allah give you the best reward. No doubt you said something that is wonderful and correct." The treasurer went away and he radiallahu ta'ala told his princesses, his beloved daughters, "Dear daughters, sacrifice your wishes for the happiness of Allah and the Holy Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. No one shall be permitted to enter Jannah till he gives some sacrifice." Allahu Akbar. Leader of the believers.
But the brother mentioned about wearing clothes and showing off. Mentioned in the hadith of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the overview of the hadith is that if anybody wears clothing or shows up due to pride, does anything due to pride, that person, that individual will not enter heaven. If anybody has got a pride equivalent to a mustard seed in his heart, that individual will not enter heaven. So like we said, we spend hundreds of pounds of clothing, and in return, what are we doing? We need to ask ourselves, are we doing this to show other people? Are we actually doing just because we want to wear it, because it's a rejoice, you know, it's a day of Eid, so we want to
after
wear
performing
it.
After performing Eid Salah, what we do? We go home, change our clothes. Like we perform our Salah, Eid Salah, with the jubbas and kurtas, right?
Yeah.
The second thing we do when we go home, right, we change our clothes.
And straight out. No even time, spending time with the family. Not even sitting with the family for a while, right? Straight out of the door. Because what we find is, we think that Eid is with friends, not with family.
Especially our sisters these days, on Eid day, they have 2 to 3 suits.
Yeah.
In the morning they have another suit, in the afternoon another suit, in the evening another suit. And they go out late night on Eid day. Our sisters should be in the house after Maghrib. They should not go out. In Eid night they go out with their friends, full of old girls without a male mahram. And they go out, driving, late night driving, go pictures, silmas, clubbing. This is the state of our sisters.
And there was the daughters of Amir al-Mu'mineen, huh? No. Who were asking the father about giving clothes, and then they had patience. They had sabr. They did not adopt new clothes. That's it. And if today, if you think about it, if the father says to the daughter or the son, he says, "Tomorrow you're not going to have clothes for Eid," what do you think is going to be the feeling? How the son or the daughter is going to feel?
On the day, parents are telling some brothers, the parents and the sister. And one thing they're doing, they leave the parents crying and they walk out. They say, "Don't you understand, it's a day of Eid," and they actually go and
do a celebration.
Day of celebration. They don't realize that they've just upset their parents. And the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says, "The pleasure of Allah Azza wa Jal lies with the pleasure of your parents, and the displeasure of your parents lies with the displeasure of Allah Azza wa Jal." So on just not that, we do so much sinful acts just on one particular day that wipes out everything. We don't realize, we as parents are sometimes, we need to reflect as well. What are we doing? Are we actually, like we said, do we actually bring our children according to Quran and Sunnah, so the child knows what is Eid? Sometimes you see little children out. Just the other day I've seen a 7-8-year-old young girl, Muslim young girl. She had sari on, where her arms were showing, her stomach was showing. And she's only 7-8-year-old. So can you really blame the children? Sometimes I've seen the parents take their children, 4-year-old, 5-year-old boy sitting in the barber with lines over here, flowers are here. A 4 or 5-year-old child, 6-year-old child, what does he know? What's on his head?
So it's like the parents actually buying the clothing for the child?
Absolutely. Absolutely. The parents, because of the parents, they don't tell them anything. They just say, it's, they're still young. they're still young, right? If you tell them about the keeping beard, right, they're still young. Didn't get married yet, man. Not yet married yet. No, this is not just happening with young children. You're talking about children here. But even the sometimes when the daughter or the son even reaches the age of 18, 19, he's not earning. He's not earning his own money. So who's buying him the clothes? The parents.
So actually, we have to learn from our pious ancestors. Look at Hazrat Sayyidina Umar bin Abdul Aziz radiallahu anhu. Many other examples have been given, Hadith Mubarak, different narrations of Buzurgan Deen, Awliya Ikram, on how they sacrificed for the day of Eid, how much they sacrificed. But look at our condition this time, brother, and viewers of Madani channel. How far are we away from the reality of following our Rabb Allah Azza wa Jal and following the Sunnah of the beloved Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam.
And especially the awliya, Allah Akbar, the way they used to celebrate Eid, Allah Akbar. How much piety they had, the fear of Allah Azza wa Jal and Allah Akbar. And look at our children these days.
I think the great example is Shaykh Tariqat Amir al-Sunnat. How Amir al-Sunnat is celebrating Eid? You know, Amir al-Sunnat is meeting people on that day. Where everyone else is with their family or out or there, and Amir al-Sunnat is meeting people, he's shaking their hands, smiling to them, just to gain the happiness of another Muslim.
I think this beautiful Madani environment of Dawood Islami has given us a chance to avoid from sins on the day of Eid. Madani Kafila, you know, sit for itikaf for 10 days. With Alhamdulillah Azawajal, 30 days, you could sit for 10 days. And Alhamdulillah Azawajal, with thousands of brothers all over the world, thousands of brothers on the Eid day, traveling on Madani Kafla, traveling in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the Eid day, where there's endless reward. Can you imagine?
No, just
everything and traveling in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of Eid.
Just one thing here, you know, you're talking about traveling in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of Eid. You know, if the viewers of Madani channel, they'll be thinking that Eid day, you want us to go into the masjid Eid day? You know, this is a time to rejoice or to be with the family. And
but the best places on the earth, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, the best places on the earth, the overview of the hadith is, the best places on the earth are the masjid, the house of Allah Azza wa Jal, and the worst places are the bazaar, the market places, the city centers. And so where are we on that day? City centers?
Okay, why are we listening to answers to travel on the Madani Kaflas on the Eid day? Why? Why he wants?
That's a big question you raise.
He wants Ummah to be saved from the sins.
This is another leeway. Actually, another leeway for the Ummah of the beloved Rasul alayhi salam to be saved from sins. Because day of Eid actually supposed to be the day of Ibadat, and day of Eid has become the day of guna of sins. Sin has become the order of the day. It has taken all our Muslims away far from the reality of the falling of Rabb Allah Azza wa Jal and the Sunnah of the beloved Rasul alayhi salam.
So my dear Islam brothers and viewers of Madani channel, let's just think for a moment and try to make good intentions for this day, the day of Eid. Alhamdulillah, we here in the environment of Dawat Islami, the brothers on the day of Eid travel in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? To protect the Iman. To protect the Iman from evil. And we all know, if we all know what's happened on the day of Eid, how Muslims are led away from the deen, how we forget, how we spend the whole of Ramadan, just on that one day. And if we really want to protect ourselves on that one day, then we need to give this time in the way of deen. Alhamdulillah, the Madani Kafirs of Dawat Islami travel even on the day of Eid to different cities, travel in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you are really concerned about protecting our Iman. My dear Islam brothers and viewers of Madani channel, you know, we've discussed many things about Ramadan, about Eid, the night of Eid, the day of Eid, how we are spending these days, and how it's going and Eid leaves us and that's it. We forget about whole of Ramadan, what happened in Ramadan, even to the extent that, you know, we have totally forgot about our deen. And the day of Eid, how the Prophet ﷺ celebrated the day of Eid, how the sunnahs of Eid, you know, going to the Eid Salah, what is the sunnahs, how the Prophet ﷺ would eat something sweet on Eid al-Fitr and not eat something going to Eid al-Adha. These are beautiful actions of the Prophet ﷺ, but we are unaware of these.
Actually, beloved Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam used to ensure that namaz fajr was read in jamaat.
And what is the state of us? Namaz. You know, you're talking about namaz here. Namaz is totally forgotten on that day of Eid. And what is the punishment of one person who misses just one namaz? His name is written on the door of hell, which he lanted to. And you know that we're talking about hell here. It's mentioned that the fire of hell is such that if someone was to be taken out of that fire and then put into the fire of this world, he'll go to sleep. Mm-hmm. My dear Islam brothers and viewers of Bandi channel, let's try to make this good intention.
Inshallah.
That, you know, as the day of Eid comes, we're going to put ourselves involve ourselves in reading namaz.
Inshallah.
We're going to aim to read every single of our prayers in the masjid.
Inshallah.
In every, no matter what happens, we're going to perform our namaz in the masjid.
Inshallah.
And inshallah, if on the day of Eid we can do this, then we can able to proceed forward.
Inshallah.
And every other day we can able to achieve this.
Inshallah.
Because shaitan is putting so much force on the day of Eid to move us away from all this, let's make intention that even in the night before Eid, we're going to try to stay up on the night and try to perform few nawafil on that night.
Inshallah.
Because it is mentioned, the narration mentioned earlier, that the hearts of the people are alive on that night when the hearts of others have died.
Allah.
So if you want our hearts to be enlightened, then namaz, the prayer is the solution. So my dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madhi channel, if you want our hearts to be enlightened, if you want to gain the light, the nur of deen, the light of deen, then we need to start performing our namaz. Not just in the month of Ramadan, but when Ramadan ends, then carrying on performing our namaz, and inshallah azawajal, with the blessing of prayer, with the blessing of performing our namaz, inshallah azawajal, we will able to enter paradise.
Inshallah.
And we will travel in a Madni kaflas as well for Eid, inshallah azawajal.
Sallu al habib sallallahu ala Muhammad. Ya Rasulullah.